Oh no, in this video, I'm going to show you how to take one of these 32x8 WS2812 matrix panels and using WLED flashed on an ESP32, make a matrix display that we can then send custom text to. I'll also show you how to get sensor data to display on the panel as well. And then we'll wrap the whole thing up with a nice Home Assistant dashboard control panel. On the board itself, I've taken one of these JST connectors. I've connected the red wire to the 5 volts there, the white wire to ground. On my board, the ground is up here. Find yourself a suitable ground on your particular board. And then on the other side, the default for WLED is GPIO 16. And I've just soldered my ring wire to that pin there. Now we've got the hardware set up, let's install WLED on our ESP32. Now I've put my board on a little bit of breadboard here just to stop the cable from pulling it about. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to hold down boot and then plug it in. Give that a couple of seconds and then let go. That's now in boot mode. Then we're going to go to this website, install.wled.me. I'm going to hit install, find the port that this is plugged into. This is a USB to UART device, so that's COM7, and hit connect. Okay, that's found it successfully, so we'll just install WLED now. That's going to go through the process of erasing the ESP32 and then installing WLED. We'll just let that run. Okay, we're almost done. There we go. So hitting next will just take you to console, but we don't need anything else on this. So just going to close that down. And then finally, what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug and plug it back in again. That'll reset our ESP32 and start the access point so we can connect to it and configure the Wi-Fi. Right, now that's done, let's go to my phone and let's change the Wi-Fi. And then we have our WLED access point there. So we'll connect to that. On my phone, I have to close that down. And then there's one here that I can sign in. So here we are on WLED. Let's go to the Wi-Fi settings first and let's do a scan. There you go. It's found my Wi-Fi network there. And then all I need to do is put in my Wi-Fi password. That's done. And we'll save and connect. That'll restart WLED and connect to Wi-Fi. So if I go back to here, go back to Wi-Fi, we can see now I've connected back to my normal Wi-Fi. Next, we'll go to the WLED app and we'll add and discover lights. So there you go. It's found WLED and one other lights. So we'll add that in there. With that installed, we can see we've got the IP address. So what we'll do is we'll go back to the computer and we'll connect to WLED on that IP address and continue with the configuration. Back in the browser, we'll go 192.168.0.219. And here we have our WLED interface. Let's connect this up. As you can see, we've got the first 30 LEDs lit up with the default orange. And let's do a couple of things in the setup. So first of all, I'm going to go to the Wi-Fi and I'm going to change this to Matrix 01. Not necessary, but it's something I like to do. So we'll just connect that. So that's going to do some reconfiguring on the Wi-Fi and the setup. So give it a couple of seconds and it will reload. Next job, let's go to the LED preferences. Now these panels are 32x8, so that's 256 LEDs. We'll just change that here, 256. We'll keep everything else as default for the moment and we'll hit save. That'll light up all of them now to the default orange. So I'm just going to turn that down here. I like to have it about 10-ish and the segment about halfway, just so it doesn't blow out the camera. And then I'm also going to turn the light down so we can see the effect with a bit more contrast. Okay, so at the moment, this panel is starting from this corner and going this way up the panel. So at the moment, it thinks it's a string of LEDs. So we want to tell it this is now a matrix of 32x8. So in settings, we'll go to 2D configuration. We'll change it from a 1D strip to a 2D matrix. And then let's give WLED some parameters for this panel. So this is 32 width this way and 8 high, top to bottom. Now these panels are not horizontal, it's vertical. So we need to change that there. And we also need to tell it it's serpentine, which means it goes backwards and forwards, up and down across the panel. And then we'll replicate those settings here in vertical and serpentine. We'll save that. Next, we'll go to user interface and I'm going to change the server description. Now I can use capitals here, so I'm going to just call this one Matrix 01. Again, I'm going to keep everything the same. That's the main settings done. Now at the moment, segment 0, which is the first segment, first bunch of LEDs, is still set to a string of 256. So we need to change that. So the X, which is the width, that's 32, and the Y is 8. And we'll just confirm that. So if we find a matrix, black hole is another favorite of everybody's. So we can see it's actually running as a matrix now. And for what we're here for is scrolling text. So we'll just speed that up again with the speed control. By default, it does the date and time. Now to change that, all we need to do is change the segment name. So if I put something like, welcome to the matrix here, that'll update. And we've now got welcome to the matrix scrolling across the screen. So over here, I'm gonna change that to green. And then I'm gonna save that as a preset. And I'm gonna call this one the matrix. So I'm gonna change there and I'm gonna hit save. Next, I'm gonna make another one. So I'm gonna change this. I'm gonna say subscribe. So we now got subscribe on there, and I'm going to change that to a lightish blue color. And again, I'm going to save a preset. I'm just going to call this one subscribe as well. So there you go. I've now got two presets, one for welcome to the matrix and another for subscribe. Now, one thing to note is if I turn this off by unplugging it, and if I plug it back in again, so it restarts WLED, you'll see that it's gone back to the default all LEDs, all orange, all the time. To change that, we want to load one of these presets on boot and restart. So if we go to config, we go to LED preferences, we scroll down to defaults, and we can see apply preset here. I'm going to go to preset number 2, and we'll save that. And if we go back, preset number 2 is subscribe. So now if I turn this off and restart it, you can see that it loads that preset now. So every time it loads, or every time you start it up, it will run that preset. Loading up Home Assistant, we can see we've got a notification. Let's have a look at that. We'll check it out. And here you can see it's found Matrix 01, which is the name we gave the device in the user interface. So it's that one there. Just hit configure and submit. I'm not using an area, won't worry about that. If we scroll down to the WLED section, we can see the matrix is there. There's the presets, so we can change that back to the presets there. First one is the brightness and the color. That comes in as a normal light. Intensity on a scrolling text, if I turn this up, you see the text goes down. And if I turn this down, you can see the text goes up. So we won't be using that for scrolling text. So we'll put that back into the middle roughly. And apart from the normal WLED settings, the only other thing we're gonna be concerned with is the speed control. So we can change the speed to there. Right, so with those in Home Assistant now, let's add some of these entities to the dashboard. So I'm gonna middle click, or you can right click and open in a new tab. In the demo, I put the entities on this Lovelace panel. So we'll do the same here again. Let's edit the dashboard. Now this is a grid card. So let's go here. I'm gonna add a new item and I'm gonna add an entities card. Well then let's get rid of these defaults in here. Going back to the settings of our WLED, we want the light first. So let's bring that entity in. Let's grab that settings, grab the lights, control C to copy that. Go back to here, drop that in there. Like so, you can see it there just about. It'll look better when I've finished making the card. Next up, let's bring in the presets. So again, settings, copy the presets, go back to here, add that to our list. Presets there, let's drop down for the presets. And finally, I brought in the speed. So just copy that, go back to here, add that to the list. So I'll save that, close it down. Now you can see in the dashboard, we've got the on and off. So we can turn that back on. We've got the presets, like so, and the speed to play with. Now we've got everything in Home Assistant with some controls. Next up, we need a way of sending data or text back to WLED. Now, if you remember in WLED itself, changing the segment name will update the scrolling text. So all we need to do is remotely change that name. To do that in Home Assistant, we're going to send a REST command. But first of all, we need to set up the REST command integration. So I'm going to be using Studio Code here. You can use whatever editor you're comfortable with. So I'm going to open up configuration.yaml. And because I like to keep mine in alphabetical order, I'm going to scroll down to where the R's should be, which is before the S is there. And I'm going to type in REST underscore command. I'm going to colon that. So that's telling Home Assistant to load the REST command. Next thing I want to do is make a REST command. Now, the first thing I need to do when making a REST command is give it a name. I've called this one WLED underscore text, colon again, to finish that line. Next thing we need to do is tell it where to send the data to. Now this is a URL, and this is going to be the full URL of your WLED instance. So for mine, it's http://192.168.0.219. That's the IP address. And then we want to add /JSON, because we're sending JSON commands, and state. Next up, we want to tell it the method of the data. And in this case, it's post. I believe post needs to be uppercase. It works, so if it ain't broke. Next, we need to tell it what we're going to be sending it. So this is going to be a payload. And what we need to do is enclose this payload in single speech marks. Now, as you can see, with VS Code, I only hit the key once, but it's added that second one there. Just keep in mind, if you're using another editor, this line will need to end in a single quote. And we need to start this line with an open curly brackets, ordinary speech marks, so that's the two ticks, seg for segment, close the speech marks, another colon. And next we're going to tell it what to send to that segment. So this is an object, so this will be square brackets. In those square brackets, we want to do an open curly brackets. Then we want to do speech marks, n speech marks again, another colon. Next, we want to tell it what to send. So what we're doing here is we're saying on segment, and this is the default segment. So this is going to be the first one. We've only got one here at the moment. If we had multiple segments, then we'd have to address those. But because we've only got one, we can leave out the ID for segment. Next, the parameter we're going to send is n. Now, n here is actually the name of the segment. So the data we're sending is going to replace this. N needs a parameter, and the parameter is the name that we want to call that segment. So that's a string. Now, instead of sending it a string, yeah, you could put whatever you want there. We want it to be a little bit more dynamic than that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a variable in there that we can change elsewhere. And to do that, we're going to do open curly brackets twice, and then we'll change the whatever you want to text. And then we need to finish the line. So we need to close off all these tags. So looking back on the line, we need to close the curly bracket first, then the square bracket, and then finally the curly bracket at the start of the line there. And then there's an extra space there, we'll just get rid of that. So that's the line. Let's get rid of our extra space there. So that's our rest command in and the parameters set for our WLED matrix and the WLED underscore text name for this command. Now, unfortunately, there's no way to reload the config.yaml. So what we have to do is restart Home Assistant. Okay, so that's all fine. And we'll just restart. Yes, restart. That's Home Assistant restarted. Now let's test our rest command. So to do that, I'm just going to go to services. I'm going to type in rest f for full. So there you can see it's found restful command and the WLED underscore text, which is the name we gave the command in config.yaml. And I'm going to select that. Data is what we're going to send to WLED. And to make it look pretty, I'm going to add a new line in between those curly brackets. I'm going to tab in or two spaces. Now, if you remember our rest commands, we had a parameter of text. That text takes a string, and that string we added a variable. So whatever we type in here, we'll update that variable. So let's do this is cool, exclamation points, close the string off, and hit call service. And there you go. There's our string updating. So we can add some other stuff here. Call service again, and it will update. Now the rest command is working. Let's build a text box and have that update from the front end. Now, in order to have a text box, we need two items. We need the text box itself and an automation that notices that text box has been changed and fires its content out to WLED. First of all, let's make a text box. So we've got a helpers, create a helper, and we want text. Let's give this a name. Let's call this one the matrix. And I'm going to give it an icon as well. I'm going to use matrix there as well, because why not? So we'll take the MDI matrix there. I want it to be a text box. I don't want it to be a password. Passwords will blank out the text box itself. So we want an ordinary text box. So we'll just create that. Now, if we scroll down to the matrix input text and look at it, we can see that it's called input text the matrix. So I'm going to copy that, just save myself a little bit of time. Next up, I want to make an automation. So we'll go back to settings. This time we'll go to automations, and I'm going to create an automation. Now, I don't want a blueprint. I want to start from an empty one. First off is the trigger. What's going to start this automation from running? Well, that's going to be the state of an entity. And I'm just going to paste in what I just copied from the input text there. And that's called the matrix. Don't need to change anything else there. The only thing we need to change now is the action. The action that I want is a call service. Remember, I did a call service when I tested out the rest command. The service I want is rest. So we'll type in rest f. So it's found our WLED text. Now, I can't add any data using the user interface. So what we need to do is we go over to these three dots menu, and we're going to go edit in YAML. And here you can see the data that we saw in services. So once again, I'm going to click in between those curly brackets, hit enter once, couple of spaces, and we're going to type in the same thing we did before. So we're going to do text colon speech marks. So we don't just want some text in here. We want the state of our entity, which is a input text. Now, to get the state of that entity, I'm going to use a little template. So it's open curly brackets twice. Then we want to do states, open square brackets, a single quote, and it's already in the clipboard. So I'm going to do control V again to get our input text, the matrix entity. I'm going to surround that with a single quote, surround that with a close square brackets to match in this one. So that's all nicely packaged within those two. Now at the moment, this is putting in all the states and I only want one state. So we're just gonna do state there. So we're looking at the state of the input text. And then we need to finish off a couple of closed square brackets to match up with the closed square brackets here. Just make sure that you're using quotes here and not a single quote. So that's the automation done. We'll save that. We'll give it a name and I'm gonna call this one update the matrix and we'll save it. So now, anytime the input text box called the matrix gets updated, this automation is going to fire. And when it fires, it's going to take the state of that input and fire it out to the rest command. So let's test it out. Back to our panel, go to edit dashboard. I'll go back to our third one here, which is our entities list. And again, still in the clipboard, so I'm going to paste that in there. And we'll close it. Let's type something in here. And then hit enter, and you can see it's updated. So yeah, that works. Right, so that's text done. Let's put some sensor data on our display. So what I'm gonna do, I've got this slider here, which is one of my tutorial sliders, and that's basically just updating this custom button card background, but we can grab that entity to play with. Like with the input text, we need an automation to read the change and to update WLED. So what we need to do is we go to automations. We're gonna create an automation, do an empty one. The trigger is gonna be the state of an entity. And in this case, it will be our slider. And as before, we want to do call service. Call service we want is restf. We'll go to the YAML again, go in between those two, hit enter, couple of spaces, text. And like we did with the input texts, we're gonna use the template, states, square brackets, single quote. I'm gonna paste in the sensor that we're using, in this case, the input number. Single quote, close, square bracket, close. We want the state of that entity, and then closed curly brackets twice, and then finish the whole line off with a quote. So every time the brightness changes, and it's called brightness, it's gonna fire the rest command with the state of that entity and fire it into the text. So we'll save that. Let's call this one brightness to matrix. So we'll save that. Go back to a slider. We should see that when I move that, the text gets updated. And if I use the arrow keys, I can slide that up and down by pressing the keys. So for anything like a temperature, or if you want any sort of data to go to the display, then running an automation is what you need to do. We only want one state, and we just need to look at the state of that box. So I can't do that with a straight face. So let's look at the states of that input text box, and we just need to look at one state, which is the state. So all we're doing is looking at the state of that box. I can't not laugh. Look at the state of that box. Why did I put that thought in my head?